71 meters high. The Minster is justly famous for its architecture, but the stained glass is equally renowned. The west front window, which is visible from the wheel, is 16.5 meters high by 7.5 meters wide. At the far end of the cathedral, the great east window is the size of a tennis court, making it the largest stained glass window in the world. In medieval times, York was England's second city, and for a brief period, the capital. In 1238, King Edward I, fighting a war against the Scots, moved his court to the city. York was a vital city to control in the Anglo-Scots Wars and during the Wars of the Roses. Contrary to what one might expect, York largely supported the Lancastrians, and one Yorkist leader's treatment in the city was particularly savage. In 1460, the Duke of York was defeated and killed at the Battle of Whitefield. His head was placed on a spike above Nipplegate Bar, the common fate of traitors and rebels, and it was a custom which did not end until the 18th century. Not long after the Wars of Roses ended in 1485, the city fell into economic decline, though it remained a place worth fighting for. One of the most important battles for the English Civil War, Marston Moor, was fought on land about 10 miles to the west. In the 18th century, York became popular as a social centre. The Georgian architecture of streets like Middlegate dates from that time. But the reason for its revived popularity was horse racing. To the southwest is the great open green space of Knavesmire, where the stands of York Racecourse are clearly visible. The first races on the site took place in 1789.